Developing story out of Ledyard tonight. A whole lot of people wondering why hundreds of dead fish have been seen floating in the local river. It's all happening in the Thames River. News 8's Tina Dattel spoke to residents to find out what exactly is going on.
Now that the tide is out, a lot of the dead fish have washed away, but there are still some left here on the shore, and it's like this all up and down the east side of the Thames River. Same side as the Harvard Boathouse, and members of that crew team saw the fish kill during their last practice.
They've never seen this before.
Bob Berry says he's seen this kind of fish kill before. It was about 30 years ago, and he says it was much worse.
Back in the early 80s, you could smell them up on Route 12, which is probably a quarter mile as a crow flies from here.
Still seeing these fish laid lifeless.
Blueback herring, menhaden, alewives, some people call them buckies.
Some still trying to hang on to life is disturbing to many who have come across the fish kills in several Connecticut rivers and the seagulls feasting on them.
There was a school that was at least a half a mile long by a quarter mile wide in the river, and you could just see the whole outline of it. That's how big these schools can actually be. So when there's that many, the ones in the middle they basically suffocate.
DEEP is investigating the cause, which may be that lack of oxygen or viral whirling disease, which in the late stages, fish are seen spinning or whirling at the surface like this. Each occur in large schools of fish, and Bob Berry says that shows these fish, which were once almost wiped out, are now thriving in the Thames.
Actually, it's a good sign if you really know what's going on.
Yeah. Again, we see another sad scene of fish here swimming in circles. And we are told that soon enough, it will be dead as well. In Gales Ferry, Tina Dattel, News 8.